Hey, what's up? Today I've got another tier list for you. This time I'm doing Super Metroid ROM hacks. I know I don't do Super Metroid that often on my channel. I have played through Super Metroid Redesign on stream and I've done Super Zero Mission, but I haven't done that much of it. But since I've played like what, maybe 12, 11 ROM hacks, I feel like I've got enough of them to do a tier list, and I'm including the original Super Metroid and AM2R in the mix as well, because they definitely count. But yeah, let's just plot these on this list and see where they all rank. So naturally, at the very beginning, like with my Doom tier list, I've got the original Super Metroid here, which is amazing. I love this game, it's revolutionary. It's one of the earliest Metroidvania genre kind of games. This is like insanely influential. The first game was probably the first in that genre, but this one really kind of defined what Metroid was. You know, you got the map system, you got the diagonal aiming and all that stuff. It's really good. Way more atmospheric than the first one. Like, the Super Nintendo was the perfect console for this type of game. And for Super Metroid, but when you compare it against these ROM hacks, it's honestly very basic. So, in that case, I'm just gonna give it right there in the middle. It's the base, you know? The B tier. I know that's a controversial opinion, but believe me, these hacks make this look very simple. Much like Doom WADs with Doom. I also would like to point out that none of these hacks are bad. Not a single one of them. They're all highly recommended and worth playing. This is just comparing them to each other, really. So after this, we've got Redesign, which this one, I love it. Personally, I would give it freaking S tier. I have so much fun with this game, but it's honestly a piece of shit. I would not give it above here. I would not rank it above the original game because it breaks so many rules that the original game has. It has like moments where you need to run through this really tight, hot area. It's so tight. Usually you only make it in with like one digit health left, the heat run, the infamous heat run. And then there's the grapple section where you need to swing along these like things, and if you drop anywhere you're dead, like there's no way out. So like death pits in Metroid, and the escape sequence is the worst thing in the whole hack. I can't stand the escape sequence. It makes you go through like quite a gauntlet of shit. And there's a crazy part at the end where no matter how good you play at the beginning, if you screw it up, you're dead and you have to do the whole escape over. It's really rough. But I do like Redesign, so I'm not gonna put it in the D tier. I'm gonna put it in C. Reimagined, it's really fine hack, but it's very jank. As far as I remember, I really don't remember much of it. It's very unmemorable to me, which is why I'm gonna place it in D tier. It's not bad though. It's pretty good. But I definitely prefer Redesign. If I'm gonna play a Super Metroid hack and I gotta pick between these two, I'm picking Redesign. Because Reimagined, just really don't remember much of it. It was alright. It's just, to me it looked like Super Metroid, but with a lot more hidden paths. It was like very hard to find the way forward, but fun. And speaking of hidden ways forward and shit like that, Z-Factor. Z-Factor is a very cryptic ROM hack. Like, it's so cryptic. It took me forever to find the way into Meridia. Like, you can get into Meridia, like, the map, but you can't actually get into the area, the main area, until you find... You have to, like, scan the whole damn thing until you find it. It's crazy. It took me forever to find it, and when I did find it, you still have to find your way into the, like, the heart of Meridia, which is where the bosses are, and that's not easy to do. Like, you really have to search everything. It's one of my favorite hacks though. I really enjoyed that search, you know, it really makes you search hard and hard and hard. I don't know how to describe it, but when I played this and I finished it, it was one of the most rewarding things ever. It's so damn good. I love Z-Factor. This is probably my favorite ROM hack of all time. Z-Factor also has the best Turian segment. It's like the coolest thing ever. Highly recommend Z-Factor. This is very hard though. I will point out this is almost as hard as Redesign. It might be like on par with Redesign, except it doesn't have the rough physics. It's just vanilla, straight up vanilla physics, as vanilla as it gets, not even respin. But I really love it. It's such an awesome experience. Next up is Super Zero Mission, and this is a remake of Metroid Zero Mission in Super Metroid's engine, but it's more than just a remake of Zero Mission. It's actually like they have their own map. Like, it's a completely new map with all kinds of new areas and new items to have, you know, to explore within, you know, within the Super Metroid engine. It's really good. It has the craziest, like, sequence of exploration if you want to get the X-ray scope. Like, they really make that challenging to find. And it has all kinds of really cool new tiles. And the progression is awesome. I like the locked door system where you have to unlock the gates. It kind of reminds me of Metroid Fusion and how you unlock the security locks and all that. It's awesome. And the progression is great. I love the reskinned bosses, the reskinned Fantoon and the reskinned Batoon and Dragon and all those guys. Yeah, it's one of my favorite hacks and I'm giving it an S tier for sure. Now we're in the Project Base ROM hacks, Hyper Metroid and Super Duper Metroid. So when I first heard about these, I learned about the fact that they were on Project Base, which is like a modified Super Metroid engine. And I was, for some reason, I always just thought that was kind of lame. I didn't like that. I didn't like the fact that they had this new engine. But I finally gave it a chance. Hyper Metroid is old, it's a classic. And I freaking loved it. It was awesome. It's so smooth. Project Base is like really fun to use. I didn't like the banging sound when you constantly go into a morph and out of the morph. It's just boom, boom. It's kind of annoying to me. But man, such a good ROM hack. The exploration in this one freaking rocks. And yeah, another highly recommended one. It's got a good color palette and it's got probably my favorite escape sequence of any of these hacks. It's a freaking epic escape sequence. I love this one, yeah, so. But I'm giving this an A. I think that's where it belongs. It's not as good as these two, in my opinion. These are my favorite. But it's so freaking good. Much better than the original Super Metroid. And Super Duper Metroid is another project-based hack. This one is really awesome. Highly recommended as well. Top-tier hack made by the same guy who did Z-Factor. And I had such a good time with it. The Super Metroid ROM hacking scene is incredible. They make just amazing games. And yeah, this is another A tier for me. Ascent. Now this one is the number one highly rated ROM hack on Metroid construction. And for a good reason, because this ROM hack kicks freaking ass. This is amazing, dude. I highly recommend Ascent. This one has a different type of progression than the others. So it's like you get these three zones, like, that are on top of each other. You start at the bottom, and you do all the little Metroid shit. You explore, you find your items, you progress, you beat the boss, and then you go away, you know, you go up. And then, when you do that, the previous area is locked off, and you just keep going up and to the top. That's how the gameplay is. And you know, a lot of people criticize the point of no return thing. But I think it's great. It's like playing three little Metroid games in one. It's really good. I love Ascent so much, and it has an awesome custom soundtrack. In my opinion, this soundtrack is way better than Super Metroid's original soundtrack. It's freaking baller. I love it. I'm putting it in an S tier, because I had a freaking incredible time with it. Phazon hack. So I played a more updated ROM hack of this one, which is the version 0.4 instead of 0.3. I don't know if this is even finished yet, but I played the whole thing. You can play it from start to finish, and it's actually really cool. It's ambitious, but it's so rough to actually play. It's one of the roughest ROM hacks I've played. It's hard for me to decide whether this one or redesign is harder, but Phazon, man, oh, it kicked my ass so hard. So there's a gimmick in Phazon where if you find all 50, I think, Phazon particles, and they're just hidden, like, in the wall, scattered around the game. If you find all 50 of them, you get the Hyper Beam, which makes the final boss significantly easier. But I did not find them. And, the final boss is significantly harder without them. Like, there's no in-between. And, man, I got frustrated on the final boss of Phazon, but, it's a really cool hack. A lot of the bosses are reskinned, and they look sweet. Like, I remember Crocomire as, like, this weird-ass robot. And, yeah. But I had a rough time with this one, so I'm gonna give it a D tier. Now, Vitality. This is really good. This is, fantastic, actually. I had an amazing time with it. By far the most cinematic Super Metroid hack I've played. It's so cool looking. It's got, like, a really dark color palette. It's a completely unique looking hack. I've never seen any hack that uses this type of atmosphere. Like, Super Metroid is kind of has a kind of a horror atmosphere, but Vitality is like, it's much more of a, it's a lot darker. That's pretty much all I can think of to describe it. But it's really, really good. And I had an amazing time with it. It's so freaking atmospheric. By far the most atmospheric of any of these hacks. It's hard for me to decide whether to put it in A tier or S tier. Because I do like these hacks more. But I think I'm going to put it in A tier. But it's so freaking good. All these are amazing, by the way. Even the D tier ones are good. But like up here, these ones are like on a whole other level. Look how many of them are just better than the original game. Like, it's amazing. Super Metroid Nature is really awesome. This has also, it has custom music like Ascent, but it also has the coolest Norfair I've ever seen. It is the coolest Norfair sequence of any of these hacks. I love how you, like, it's been a long time since I played Nature, like more than a year, but like there's a crazy escape sequence through Norfair, and there's like, you're like racing against lava that's rising and stuff, and you fight Ridley in the middle of all that, you know? And then you get out and you continue the escape. It's freaking amazing. I love this ROM hack. I think I'm gonna put it in B tier, because I don't remember much different from Super Metroid. I think this is better than the original Super Metroid. Here's what I think of Super Metroid Nature. If you've beaten Super Metroid, this is the perfect first ROM hack to play. Don't start with redesign like I did. This was the biggest mistake in any video game. This was the biggest video game mistake I ever made, by far. This ROM hack tore me 12 new assholes when I played it, because I was nowhere near. I was literally, the only thing I played before it was the original, so yeah. Super Metroid Subversion is the newest hack I've played. This came out in just last year, 2022, August. And it's amazing. This is an S tier, instant S tier for me. I knew it was good the moment it came out, because I saw people who don't even play Super Metroid hacks streaming it, and I was like, well, okay, this must be something that's gathered a lot of buzz. And it did. It's freaking incredible. I love Subversion so much. It's this is another contender for a hack that you should play after Super Metroid. This one and Subversion are the two that I would recommend if you just finished the original and want to play some more Metroid. These are better than like any official Metroid 2D game that Nintendo ever made, by far. These are just, they kick so much ass. And AM2R, speaking of Metroid games that Nintendo never made, right up in the S tier. I played this one like, I don't know, 6 years ago on my channel. I did like a full playthrough where I pre-recorded the whole thing and put it on. It took me like 3 hours. And yeah, it's a masterpiece. It's just one of the best fan projects I've ever seen. It's up there with Black Mesa. So in the spirit of Metroid, you don't even need to learn anything about it if you've played these other games. If you've played Super Metroid, if you've played freaking Zero Mission, you can jump right into this game and you'll be right at home. It's amazing. I love AM2R. And yeah, if you like Metroid and you haven't played this, get it on your freaking PC as soon as possible. It's free. Just Google it and download it. I wish I could link it, but I kind of can't do that. So, but these ROM hacks, I'll link them in the description. And you can download either of them, and you can play them. And patching them is real easy. All you got to do is use floating IPS, and bam. It's the easiest thing ever. And you can play all these amazing custom games for free. Yeah. That's the beauty of it. These are amazing games that few people know about. So yeah, if you feel like it, grab them and play them. So yeah, that's my list of Super Metroid hacks. I hope you enjoyed it. That was fun to make. I always love doing these rankings. This shit's fun. I think I'm gonna do this with like Quake mods and Half-Life 2 mods in the future. I don't know. We'll see. With that said, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.